Hey everyone, Shadow here, and welcome to another Marvel Contest of Champions video. So it's season 12, and this is war number 6, so we are halfway through the season. And we're going up against an alliance called Agent Orange, and they look challenging. And we're going to try to win this war. Now, you see the team that I decided to go in here with. I've already scouted out my paths for both Section 1 and 2. I also looked over the mini-bosses, and I felt that these three were my best options. So I take path one in section one, and you see that they did not place a defender there. That's a pretty common thing. And so my first fight is against Aegon. All right, this is the Starburst path. He's got Limber, and those defense tactics made me dip down there to see what his size it was. He's medium, so I don't have to worry about him auto evading and getting power from those defense tactics. Alright, so, as you can see here, Gladiator Hulk activated his Face Me. That is what makes Gladiator Hulk such a beast, and what makes him the best option for this path. I have yet to find someone that Gladiator Hulk could not defeat on this path. So, Aegon is not proving to be any exception whatsoever. Here we go, Special 2. Finish it off. So down goes Aegon without too much difficulty. So now I need to wait for my teammates to clear their paths. That Iceman, I don't have a good counter for him. The Psychic Thorns, just not a good look. Fortunately, they were able to come in and take out that Iceman. So now we are ready for Section 2, and in this section, I take Path 2. I'm staying away from that Path 1 after War Number 3, where I got totally wrecked by that Killmonger. But in any case, Path 2, I have the champions for this path. And because of our tier, the nodes are a little different than the ones that I was used to. But Captain America Infinity War has no problem with this Ultron. Now, I don't like fighting this Ultron. I actually prefer fighting the other Ultron. This one likes to evade at random times. Don't like him. Okay, so I fight a little conservatively because I know, like that, he's just going to evade sometimes. So I do have a tech on the team. So that is why you see the Petrify. And look at that. Special 2. It didn't take him out, but it took most of his health, stunned him, down he goes. Captain America Infinity War is a beast. I don't play with him too often, so I'm not as well versed with using him. So you may see a few mistakes here and there. All right, so here we go again. We've got defense tactics, and she is small. Okay, so in this fight, we've got several things going on. First of all, we have defense tactics, so she's going to have an auto evade. And we also have her limbo to deal with. So combined with both of those things, where she auto evades, gets power, and she has that limbo, I felt Gladiator Hulk was the best choice for this. Because when she activates limbo, Gladiator Hulk activates Face Me. And he heals up most of that damage, okay? So he's actually a very good counter for this magic. Now, notice how I'm fighting. I am not doing 5-hit combos, okay? I'm hitting 1, 2, 3, maybe 1, 2, 1. I'll hit once if I know that that one hit is going to push her to a bar of power. Then I will just hit one time to see if it procs limbo. If it procs limbo, I back off. All right, and there you go. She had that power flood real quick. You know, so you want to play her a little carefully. All right, one hit, if it's going to push her to a bar of power, see if it procs limbo, like there. Two bars of power, you see I only hit one time. Watching for that limbo. Bait out that special. And then just keep playing. Hope that I don't get too many limbos, but with Gladiator Hulk, it doesn't really matter. It would take a lot more limbos than she's going to be able to do in 3 minutes. to take down Gladiator Hulk with that, okay? So we're doing pretty well. I'm not a fan of this style. If you guys know how I usually fight, I like to fight very aggressively. So I'm in your face, push them all the way to the right-hand side of the screen, and just keep them there. So this cat and mouse style playing just doesn't fit my personality, doesn't fit my preferred playing style. But you got to do what you got to do. Magic goes down. I stayed up. It's a good time. All right. Took a little bit longer than I would like, but we got it. All right. Now, this next fight, as you can see, I had to wait for them to clear off their path for this domino. When I came back, nobody wanted to fight that domino. I don't blame them. Don't like domino. But I've got Starkey. He is a great domino counter. And he's at full health. So it's early in the morning. Everybody's asleep. And I see this. I saw the message. And I'm like, all right, I'm just going to boost up. And I'm going to go after this domino. Okay? So how I like to fight her is to evade, bait out that medium like that, and then go right back in. But as you see, she's also small. So I'm dealing with the auto evade as well. Not a bad placement. She's very annoying. I try not to finish my combos. No 5-hit combos. Now you saw that where I just punched in the air. Don't know what was happening. Not surprised that I suddenly got hit because that threw me off completely. And then look at this. You know, I thought I was going to be able to finish it. Of course she evades right there. I don't know. I don't call that RNG when it seems to happen right when they need it. I don't know if I would consider that as random as we would like to believe. Happens too often. Happens too regularly. All right, but we got her down. Now, I still had my buffs up, and I made a poor decision on this one. Now, I'm not used to fighting Sabretooth, okay? And I read the nodes, but I didn't fully process what those nodes meant. So, Captain America Infinity War is normally a great option for fighting this Sabretooth. When I scouted the path out, I saw him, and I was like, well, I'll have Starkey so I can do Petrify. But a couple of things. One, I'm stuck on my power one. That's one of the nodes. So Captain America Infinity War does his best damage on his special two. I don't have that. Secondly, he's debuff immune, thanks to this node. So I can't put the petrifies on him to stop his regen. And I couldn't even put the bleeds, I couldn't do anything to stop that regen. When I saw that, I started faltering because now I'm worried that I'm not going to be able to finish this fight with him at a low health. He might regen all of his health back up. So right there, I just pretty much gave up. I looked, I saw the regens. Maybe I could have finished this fight better. Maybe I could have let those fall off, but I panicked. I didn't want him regaining all of that health. So I decided to just go ahead, throw it, and then wait here, see if they want me to finish him off. I can finish him off with Starkey or with Gladiator Hulk. So we'll see. Oh, you thought I was done? You thought I would stay down? Nah, son. Coming back for you, man. So I got the go-ahead to go back in here and take care of this Sabretooth. So you see, I boosted up a little bit. And I should have used Starkey from the start. Build up to 10 poise charges and then just wreck him. But I was trying to save him for a later fight or a later potential fight. But I should have just went ahead and used him and not worried about it. All right. So we built up a few poise charges, but I'm like, well, he's almost down anyway, so I don't need to build up all the way to 10. And as you can see here, took a little bit of block damage, but down he goes. So not a hard fight. I just chose the wrong person. And I could have done it, I think, with Cap Infinity War, but I'm just still not good with Captain. I still need more practice with him, and I needed more practice fighting Sabretooth. Normally, when I fight him, it's Archangel that I use against him. All right, so now, this guy right here, that's who I wanted to fight with my Spider-Man Stark Enhanced. That is food for my Starkey. So, as you saw there, I looked around, looked at the condition of my teammates here, and I said, okay, we going for him. We want that boy right there. But my health is a little low. We are going for the win. I checked my boost, still boosted up. I have a few of the health potions, use a couple of those just in case. I didn't think I would need them, but I didn't want to need them and not have that extra health, you know? All right, so basically just build up Starkey's poise charges. If I had Blade, I would build these up even faster, but not too hard. I'm getting pushed to the corner. I don't like it. And now it's time for me to shine. Here we go. Yeah, buddy. Rip him up, rip him up. Fire off that special two. Couple of crits. Look at that damage. Look at that damage. And he is done. Stick a fork in him. All right. Now, I paused after this. I was not trying to deal with that Captain Marvel movie mini up there. So I went ahead and let my Alliance mates take care of that. All right, so let's find out how we did. All right, and we're back. And we've got 30 seconds left to find out how we did in this war. According to what I saw, we should have this win. We've got less deaths, and I believe we have them beat on diversity. But time will tell. We've got less than 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Show me the money. Results will be available soon. No, I want them now. All right, let's check our history. And we won. That is a huge win for us. That should place us firmly in platinum. So that's going to do it, guys. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Click like, subscribe, leave a comment. Let me know what you thought about this video. And you all have a blessed day.